Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Om Swastiastu, salam kebajikan. Your Excellencies, Your Honors, ladies and gentlemen. First of all, allow me to thank you all for your presence and valuable contribution in the biggest democracy event in the Asia-Pacific region. As a member of the People's Representative Council of the Republic of Indonesia, I would like to convey our full support for the constructive spirit built on the 12th Bali Democracy Forum, namely democracy and inclusivity. One of the main roles of the People's Representative Council is to guard the pace of democracy in an inclusive manner. This role is in line with our endeavor towards transparency and accountability, as stated in our commitment for parliamentary openness in 2018. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, the history of modern Indonesia Parliament began on 29th of August 1945, when our President Sukarno formed the Central Indonesian National Committee. It was the first post-independent parliament, which is an indicator of Indonesia as a democratic nation. Since then, Parliament in Indonesia has gradually become a central institution that is relied on to complete the transition for democracy, especially after the reforms movement in Indonesia, and at the same time laid the foundation for the process of democratic consolidation in the country. Indonesia is now currently one of the largest democratic countries in the world, in which 82%, or about 158 million voters, out of a total of 199.9 million voters, participated in the 2019 elections. This progress in democracy has long been shared by Indonesia through Bali Democracy Forum, an inclusive and open intergovernmental forum, where countries and other stakeholders from the Asia-Pacific region discuss about the development of democracy, particularly in the region. BDF was born from a strong belief that the promotion of democracy is an indivisible part of Indonesia's foreign policy. BDF was created to help build a democratic architecture in the region through sharing experiences and best practices by adhering to the principle of equality, mutual understanding, and of course, respect. Distinguished participants, in the past 2 days, we have jointly participated in the 12th Bali Democracy Forum in Nusa Dua, Bali, with Democracy and Inclusivity as its theme. In total, 461 people representing 87 countries and 7 international organizations has participated in the 12th Bali Democracy Forum. This forum was opened with a welcoming remarks from the Minister for Foreign Affairs, Ibu Retno Marsudi, in which she highlighted some of the challenges of today's democracy. First, that economic inequality affects public views about democracies. And secondly, that political polarization will lead to violations of the principles and norm of democracy. Thirdly, that manipulation of social media will damage democracy itself. And lastly, that there has been democratic setback by a number of democracy bearers. These challenges were discussed in the BDF's discussion panels A, B, C, and D, which we attended yesterday. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, this year's Bali Democracy Forum highlights the important role of women as one of the pillars of inclusive democracy. Recognition of the principle of equality of political rights and equity between women and men begins with the belief that democratic state needs to facilitate all voices of people from various social backgrounds. Therefore, the participation of women in decision-making process affecting their lives and communities becomes an important part of democracy itself. These women's roles support democratic resilience of the country, especially in the current geopolitical dynamics. Democratic resilience is needed to strengthen state institutions and promote a culture of inclusiveness as a prerequisite for SDGs. Therefore, one of the attempts to increase democratic resilience of one country is to increase women's involvement in the process of democratization towards an inclusive democracy. For that, women's perspective are important requirements. In this regard, The 12 PDF conducted a special panel for women that focused on the relations and urgency between women's leadership, inclusiveness, and democracy. This is in line with the SDGs and efforts to preserve the sustainability of gender equality agenda, as well as sustainable development. And in the last 2 days, we have also witnessed various perspectives and insights on the challenges in fostering inclusive democracy and efforts needed to overcome these challenges. I sincerely hope that all participants could benefit from this forum with plenty of experiences, lessons learned, and new ideas to contribute to their respective countries' democratic ideals. On behalf of Indonesia, I would like to thank all delegations who participated and contributed to the success of this forum. We also thank the panelists for giving us fresh insight, as well as the facilitators who help us expediting our discussion. I would also like to convey our gratitude to our fellow journalists who helped us echoing the message derived from this forum. And of course, for the organizers of this event, thank you for the hard work and dedication devoted to making 12th BDF run smoothly. Excellencies, distinguished participants, thus we hereby declare the 12th BDF completed. I hope that all participants can wrap up the democratic inclusiveness message received in this forum as valuable tokens for their respective countries, and I wish you all safe flight on your way home. Thank you again. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Om Santi Santi Om. Salam kebajikan.